Great. Yeah.
With shout of acclamation.
Yes,
and take me home.
Amen.
What joy does fill my heart. Hallelujah. We're asking God to remember all the bereaved families. Most of all, our pastor and first family of this church. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. God is doing a work. Amen. God is doing a work in this place. Amen. If you have any additional prayer requests, let them be known now. Sister Bowden. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
Sister Blandon.
I pray for me, my entire family, and my daughter and grandson, and they're on their way back from Iowa.
Amen. Amen. Sister Tracy.
Continue to pray for me. Continue to pray for Kiara and Kiara's serenity in a very special way. Pray for those that speak in the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Pray for.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
Jesus.
God knows.
Pray for the Quint community. Pray for
Thank you, Jesus.
Pray for our church in general. Pray for those that was baptized here and need to come back. Pray a special prayer for me.
Amen.
I'm asking the saints to continue to pray that I get the understanding and the wisdom and the knowledge of the word.
Thank you, Jesus.
And that I stay grounded in the word.
Yes.
I'm asking the saints to continue to pray for my family in its entirety. A special prayer for LaMarco and Micaiah and my parents and siblings.
Amen.
Amen.
Pray for me and my family. Special prayer for those that are seeking the Holy Ghost. Pray for those that have received the Holy Ghost and strayed. Pray for those that need strength in the Lord and those that just want to draw close to Him and hear His voice. Pray for my strength in the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord, Sister Pope. Saved family and my saved family. Amen. And there be no other requests. Have thine own way, Lord. Thine own way. Thou art the potter. I am the clay. Thank you. God, we come humbly before your throne of grace, thanking you and praising you, Lord, for this day, for this very hour. We thank you, praise you, Lord Jesus, for your grace, for your mercy. Hallelujah, for your hallelujah, your care for your people, Lord Jesus. We thank you for this place of worship. Hallelujah, that we come to hear a word, Lord Jesus, from you. My God, we ask you to bless the man of God today. Strengthen him on every hand. My God, strengthen the mind, body, and soul. My God, remember the souls that came in today. Lord Jesus, we come, Lord Jesus, before you, Lord. My God, the holy way we know how, Lord. Hallelujah, we come before your throne of grace, asking you, Lord Jesus, to do a miracle in this place. Lord Jesus, we ask you, Lord Jesus, to make a way out of no way, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, let souls come in and be saved in the name of Jesus. We ask you, Lord Jesus, let this house, Lord Jesus, be to thy glory, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to help us, strengthen us in your will, Lord Jesus, to build this house, oh Lord, to take the land, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to help us to humble ourselves, Lord Jesus, that you might work a work in this place. Strengthen us, oh Lord. God, our minds, Lord, in the way that we should go. My God, help us not to lean to our own understanding, but Lord, in all thy ways, Lord. We acknowledge you, Lord. Strengthen us, oh Lord. Keep us, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We ask you to touch our bodies, Lord. There's illnesses in the body. My God, we ask you to touch, heal, and deliver. My God, we ask you, Lord Jesus, to save us. Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, my God. Hallelujah. To help us to lay down every weight and sin that's so easily besetting us, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to help us to be a better life. Lord Jesus, to present our bodies, hallelujah, a living sacrifice, Lord Jesus, holy and acceptable in thy sight. My God, we ask you, hallelujah, not to be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of the word, my God. My God, help us to take heed, Lord Jesus. In the name of 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 Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You don't have any victory. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. We have the victory in the blood of Jesus. In that name, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Every wall, hallelujah, must be torn down. Hallelujah. There's no weapon formed against us that shall prosper. Hallelujah, God. We ask you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The leading God, our pastor, Lord Jesus, in the vision that you've given him. My God, we thank you for the young people. Strengthen them on every hand. Pour the Holy Ghost in this place. Renew a right spirit in us, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Give us a clean heart and a right mind, Lord, to do your will. Let our conversation be right before you. Lord Jesus, let us walk right before you. Hallelujah. Help us to live holy before you, Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we ask you to remember each and every prayer request. In the mighty name of Jesus, we ask you to remember each and every bereaved family, those who are sick and shut in. My God, bless in the name of Jesus, we pray. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Come on, give God some praise. Hallelujah, but we got the victory. Come on, we got the victory. Hallelujah, we got the victory. In the name of Jesus, we got the victory. Come on, somebody. We got the victory in the name of Jesus. God is going to do a work in this place. Amen. Let us get excited. Hallelujah. God is in the place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. We ask you to remain standing and get your Bibles out and say amen for Evangelist Ware as she leads us in our scripture reading.
Amen. Hallelujah. Psalms 11 in responsive reading. When you have it, say amen.
Amen.
In the Lord put I my trust. How say ye to my soul? Flee as a bird to your mountain.
They made ready their arrow upon the string, that they may fairly shoot and upright their heart.
If the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do?
The Lord is in his holy temple. The Lord's throne is in heaven. His eyes behold, his eyelids try the children of men.
The Lord trieth the righteous, but the wicked and him that loveth violence, his soul hateth.
upon the wicked he shall rain snares, fire and brimstone, and horrible tempest. This shall be the portion of their cup.
Seven altogether. For the righteous Lord loveth righteousness. His countenance doth behold the upright. And may the Lord bless you to the reading of his word. I've got a feeling everything's going to be all right.
Oh,
I'm
Yes. Thank you, Lord. Pastoral anniversary and evening out with Pastor and First Lady Dumas, chosen and ordained with a heart to serve. Saturday, March 12th, 2016, at Weber Inn at 6 p.m. in Ann Arbor, Michigan. The cost is $50 per adult. It is semi-formal attire. The guest speaker is Bishop Gary Harper, which is our diocesan of the Ghana Council and pastor of Greater Grace Temple Taylor. The celebration continues Sunday, March 13th at 11 a.m. with guest speaker Minister Gary Hudgens of St. Peter's Holiness Church, who is also the Eastern District Union President. Amen. Greater Northside Apostolic Faith Church is having their annual missionary day. Take some of the echo out, please. Sunday, February 21st at 4 p.m. Speaker of the hour is Evangelist Jean Gatewood of Faith and Truth Apostolic, where pastor is Pastor Glenn S. Gatewood. Greater Northside Church family is looking forward to having you come out to worship and praise the Lord with us. Chairperson is Sister Nancy Matthews. Northern District Council Pentecostal Young People's Union Retreat 2016. Theme is Position for God's Favor. Our speakers are Pastor Joel Urshan, and Suffragan Bishop James Rogers. Amen?
Amen.
I don't know about you, but I'm looking forward to this retreat.
Amen.
Pastor Joel Urshan, I just heard a snippet of him preaching, and that made me excited for Friday. And Suffragan Bishop James Rogers is the only bishop that has a Baptist church in the PAW, so I really want to hear him.
Amen.
Amen. This again will be at the Causeway Bay in Lansing, Michigan. Registration is open. You can get your rooms now. It's $109 per night with code NDC2016. Amen?
Amen.
Registration is $25 until March 1st. And then after that, it is $30 on site. Amen?
Amen.
Please, please, please register. Register. The Northern District Council Pentecostal Young People's Union is also having the Winter Blast Revival 2016 on February 6th at 7 p.m. at Christ Temple Church in Lansing, Michigan, where the pastor is Suffragan Bishop Lewis Slaughter. The ministers will be Minister Josh Reb, who is our Sergeant at Arms, yours truly, who is the Vice President, Minister Demetrius Phillips, the Treasurer, Evangelist Anisha Shaw, who is over the evangelism team, and Minister Noah Nicholson, who is in our praise and worship team. Amen. Please be in attendance. Greater Grace Temple Taylor is having their 30-40 celebration honoring the 30th church anniversary and Bishop Gary Harper's 40 years in ministry. March 1st, the tickets are $100 per person. The dress is semi-formal, and the deadline to RSVP is February 1st, which is next week. Amen. Well, week after next. Week after next. Amen. This is at the Sheraton Hotel in Romulus, Michigan. Also, the Western District Union is having their first service in April on the 2nd, and yours truly will be their day speaker on that Saturday. Amen?
Amen.
Building Fund Sunday is every first Sunday.
Amen.
Please don't forget your $100 every first Sunday.
Yes.
Okay, you see it's a little brighter in here?
Amen.
Because we got some new windows.
Yay.
Amen. Next thing is the doors.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Then the block.
Yay.
Then Walgreens. Yay. Amen. Then don't, please, please, please don't forget what we are fasting for. Amen. Amen. Who can tell me what we're fasting for?
The open doors.
The open doors.
Strength.
Strength and the Holy Ghost to fall in this place.
Amen.
The open doors is for us to obtain the block. And the Walgreens. Mm-hmm. And there was one more.
Strength, path, and rejuvenation of
there's three that the pastor said. There's three that the pastor said. Open doors to obtain the block in Walgreens, for the Holy Ghost to fall into place, and for us to gain more understanding and knowledge of God's word.
Amen.
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 Amen. That's one of the most important things.
Amen.
So please, please, don't forget those three things.
Amen.
We've added on our own things.
Right,
we want strength.
Right.
We want the pastor's toe to grow back. We want his kidneys to come back to full function. Yes, we want those. But our top three, we want those as well. Amen.
Amen.
And we see God and we feel God working already.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
We are online. ACJesus.net. You can like us on Facebook and friend us on Facebook. Follow us on Twitter. Follow us on Periscope. Watch us live on Ustream and subscribe to us on YouTube. Amen?
Amen.
ACJ Youth Department invites you to follow with us as we read the Bible in 1 year. We are on the blended plan. The blended plan. How many are caught up first?
Amen.
Where are we?
Isaiah 7 and 8 and Mark 3.
Amen. Isaiah 7 and 8 and Mark 3. If you have missed a day, a week, 3 weeks,
well,
please be honest. You owe us a quarter for every day you missed. Amen?
Amen.
Our weekly schedule for the month of January is as follows. Monday night, Hour of Power.
Amen.
At 7 p.m.
Don't forget to fast.
Don't forget to fast. And we're having a Bible study.
Yes.
I don't know about open forum. But we're
it.
Having Bible study. On Monday.
Amen.
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 Wednesday night, Hour of Power.
Amen.
Tuesday night, Hour of Power. Excuse
Amen.
Me. At 7 p.m.
Amen.
Wednesday, there is no service because the pastor is teaching Bible class in Lansing.
Amen.
For, yes. Amen. which our own Sister Jade Holloway is over.
Amen.
So we are traveling to Lansing for Bible class. If you are interested, we are leaving at 6. What time is Bible class?
7:00.
Okay, we're leaving at 5:45.
Amen.
Amen. So no church here on Wednesday. Thursday night, Hour of Power.
Amen.
With choir rehearsal following.
Amen.
Oh, it is the last week. Communion on Thursday.
Amen.
And Friday, don't forget to fast. We're still having prayer when we come in. And we'll have our guest speaker, Pastor Philip Thompson, as our speaker for our revival to end our consecration. Amen. Amen. Communion is on Thursday and revival is on Friday.
Amen.
Friday the fast ends at 4 p.m. Amen.
Amen.
This is the last push. This is the last push. If you've been cheating a little bit, don't cheat this week. If you've been cheating a little bit, don't cheat this week. This is the last push of consecration.
Amen.
It can't be too bad. Somebody literally stuck a chicken wing in my face to try to make me eat it.
Wow.
And I didn't even smell it. Thank
all
you,
right.
Jesus.
All right.
So, this is the last week. Push through.
Amen.
Amen. Come to prayer. We'll be in Bible class on Wednesday in Lansing.
Amen.
Communion is on Thursday.
Amen.
Amen. Make sure you have repented so you're not taking communion in vain. Amen.
Amen.
We don't want to take communion to curse us. We want to take communion to bless us because we're remembering why we have communion in the first place.
Amen.
We're honoring God's body being broken up on the cross for our sins and Him shedding His blood for us to save us. Amen.
Amen.
That is in remembrance of what Jesus did. So make sure, please make sure you are doing it for the right reasons. Don't just come for the wine and tasteless crackers.
Amen.
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 And don't try to get the biggest cracker either.
Well,
this is not to feed us and this is not to get drunk off of.
Amen.
Amen. This is a ceremony that we take seriously.
Amen.
Ladies, please don't forget your all white on Thursday. Gentlemen, black suits, white shirt, red tie. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. His blood washes whiter than snow.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
And everybody ought to go to
Sunday school.
Moms and pops and?
Children too.
Everybody ought to go to
Sunday school.
At what time?
5 a.m.
Amen.
Right.
And Sunday morning service at 11:30 a.m. Amen.
Amen.
These have been your announcements. Please govern yourselves accordingly. Now we will have the Apostolic Church of Jesus, Voices of Praise, come to render unto us two selections. Let's receive them with a hearty amen.
Amen.
There is a name.
There is a name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Yes. Yes.
Come on. Clap your hands. Come on. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. Let's bless the Lord. Come on. Come on. Wake up. Wake up.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Come on. Come on. Bless the Lord in here. Come on. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And I will bless
the Lord,
oh my
soul,
and
all
that is within me,
bless His holy name.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
And Come on. Praise Jesus in here.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Amen. Lord, you're worthy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together for the choir. Didn't they sound beautiful this morning? Hallelujah. Amen. We're not going to prolong the time. Amen. We're going to ask you to stand to your feet. And welcome the man of the hour, the man of this house. Amen. Our pastor, Southern Good Bishop Clifton David Hope, with a hearty praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Sister Holloway.
Amen.
Trouble in my way, Lord.
Trouble in my way.
I have to cry sometime.
I have to cry sometime.
So much trouble. I have to cry sometime. I lay awake at night. Testimonies. If you weren't here Friday night, you just missed it.
Amen.
Many great testimonies, and it's just a reality check to show us that God knows what He's doing.
God knows.
He pays bills.
Oh, hallelujah!
He gives you more than you. Than you're worth.
Come on now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
He's just a good God.
Amen.
In every way. As I said, I thank God that I'm supposed to be receiving a new kidney. I'm supposed to be on dialysis, really. But God has blessed me. And I haven't been on dialysis as of yet.
Amen.
I don't feel the greatest, but I don't feel like I need to be on that yet, and I'm praising God for that. Let's go to Hosea, the third chapter. If you got it, say amen.
Amen.
Then said the Lord unto me, go yet, love a woman, beloved of her friend, yet an adulteress, according to the love of the Lord toward the children of Israel, who look to other gods and love flagons of wine.
So I bought her to me for 15 pieces of silver. And
I said unto her, thou shalt abide for me many days. Thou shalt not play the harlot, and thou shalt not be for another man. So will I also be for thee.
For the children of Israel shall abide many days without a king, and without a prince, and without a sacrifice, and without an image, and without an ephod, and without a teraphim.
Together. Afterwards shall the children of Israel return and seek the Lord their God and David their king and shall fear the Lord and his goodness in the latter days. Can we all say amen?
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, for your kindness today and for your blessings. We ask, Lord, that you will look on us as we bring forth thy word, that you will bless and give us strength according to thy will. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
God. God certainly has. Again, it's amazing the things that God does. Yet they're ordinary things with Him, but they're amazing to us.
Amen.
I'm thanking God to know the truth.
Yes.
One of my ministers spoke to me and said she listened to other ministers and say they don't have what they have, what God has given us.
Amen.
And truly, because we are small, doesn't mean God has forgotten us.
That's right.
For God has truly blessed us immensely.
Amen.
He has blessed us immensely. There's churches that fold because they have a small congregation like we have. But we have met our obligations.
Hallelujah.
In the Lord. Even with those that didn't pay any tithes. We've yet met our obligation.
Thank you, Jesus.
And those that paid their tithes, God kept His promise.
Yes, He did.
God kept His promise.
Hallelujah.
He said, I'll open up windows.
Come on now.
Pour out a blessing.
Come on, open them, Lord.
And there shall not be room enough to receive. God has done that.
Yes.
You know, it's not something that I've had to pump anybody to tell. They just want to tell it on their own.
Amen.
The Lord is good. It's just amazing what God does. We're going to the 15th chapter of 1 Corinthians. And we're going to begin about the 12th verse. 15 and 12 of 1 Corinthians. Now if Christ be preached that He rose from the dead, how say some among you that there is no resurrection of the dead? But if there be no resurrection of the dead, then is Christ not risen? And if Christ be not risen, then is our preaching vain, and your faith also vain. Yea, and we are found false witnesses of God. Because we have testified of God that He raised up Christ, whom He raised not up. If so be that the dead rise not. For if the dead rise not, then is not Christ risen. And if Christ be not risen, your faith is vain. Ye are yet in your sins. Then they also which are fallen asleep in Christ are perished. Mm. If in this life only we have hope in Christ, we are of all men most miserable. But now is Christ risen from the dead and become the first fruit of them that slept. Heavenly Father, bless again this day, we pray. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
If in this life only we have hope in Christ, we are of all men most miserable. Where is your hope?
Where is your hope?
Where have you put your hope?
All right.
We thank God that He has kept us throughout the years. You know, when you begin to contemplate or meditate on God's word and you listen to men when they speak, especially those that want to make us look most silly, you're trusting in somebody you can't see. You're trusting on a God that is the white man's God. They say all several different things. And man running for president, they say now, say he's going to church. Say he's a Christian. You ain't heard him speak about Christ in all the time that you've known him, but now he's a Christian. our elections that are coming are far-fetched. They are crazy. And the crazier, as the man told him, the crazier I get, the more you love me. That's what he said when he said, I could stand out on Broadway and shoot somebody. And he said, I would not lose a vote. In other words, he called them stupid. He actually called them stupid. That you would go for me no matter what I do. And he recognizes that the talk that he is speaking is for the crazy folk. The same folk are not listening to it. Well, there is a lot of crazy folk in the world. And they want to portray that the saints of God are crazy. They want to portray that we're missing out on the world's goods, on all the pleasure that the world has out there for us. Now also, a lot of times when I read this, I'm reminded of I can't remember that preacher's name, the preacher that I was at my brother's church, and the man preached about the devil giving a man a ladder. And the man climbed up the ladder, and as he was on the ladder, the devil came back and says, I need my ladder. And he says, oh, hold on right now. I'm not finished right now. Because he was enjoying the pleasures of the world. And the devil said, I need my ladder. He said, just hold on a minute. I'll give it back to you. And the devil got angry and said, and snatched his ladder. And said, I need my ladder. So you know where the man fell when the devil snatched his ladder. But he was having a good time as long as he was on that ladder. Which is what the enemy wants to do to us. Satan doesn't fight the world as much as he fights the saints of God. The world is having too much fun. They are doing what they want to do, when they want to do it, in any way that they desire to do it. And nothing that Satan can do to them can change their mind to make them want to serve God. You know, he tells them that God is a forgiving God and that at the last minute, God is so forgiving that you can repent and God will save you on the spot. What the world hasn't realized yet is that the devil is a light.
Amen.
He is the father of lies. He hasn't changed his tactics. He's the same devil. And a lot of times we see images drawn of what the devil looks like. Big, mean monster. Terrible dragon monster. But my Bible tells me in Isaiah that when we shall see him and look upon him, we shall say, is this the man that caused such havoc in the world? That caused us to do such crazy things? The saints of God mainly are tempted many times to go aside from God and to enjoy the pleasures of the world. Because the world tells us we go to church too much.
Come on now.
We don't have to go to church that much. They say, I go to church. We go to church every Sunday. We spend about 45 minutes in church.
Uh-huh.
And then we're finished until the next Sunday. And so we are Christians, just like you're a Christian. And we look at that. I remember when, just being a young man, listening to the radio and the preachers on the radio. And it hit my mind, they're preaching like we preach. So when folks tell me, because I met one young lady from with the St. Paul with us, and she told me her preacher in the Church of God in Christ was preaching the same thing that H.J. Hope, Elder H.J. Hope was preaching at St. Paul. I said, no, he isn't. She said, yes, he is. I said, oh, no, he's not. He's not preaching the same thing. She said, I don't want to talk. I said, okay, fine. We won't talk. So I left her alone. Because if you don't want to go to heaven, you had that privilege. For he says, choose you this day whom you will serve. And so the thing is, the devil tells you that the Lord is not coming on tomorrow. They've been saying that the Lord has been coming for years. Look at Elder Hope. He's 75 years old. They've been saying it ever since he can remember. And the Lord ain't got here yet. Well, what you don't realize is God has gotten here for a lot of folk. A lot of folk, God has already come. Already, judgment is set and will not change. But here Paul is talking in the 15th chapter. He's telling us how vain our faith in Christ is if only we have hope in this life. Now, I hope to have another building for Apostolic Church of Jesus. We hope for windows, and now they have manifested themselves, and we haven't. Most folk want God to work the miracle like he did with the wine. They poured the water in and immediately pulled out wine. God doesn't work that way all the time. He works on his own time and in his own way. But the enemy tells us we're crazy. There is so much going on in the world. There is so much happening that we are missing out on. We can't do this and we can't do that. We can't go here and we can't go there. I want you to understand, there is no place that you can't go long as God gives you strength.
Yes, sir. All right.
And you have the ability to get there. You can go and come as you choose.
Yes, sir. All right.
You can do what you desire to do. In fact, the Bible tells us to do so. It says, let your heart cheer thee.
Come on now.
Let your eyes give you all the pleasure that they can give.
All right.
And so Paul is saying, talking to the saints of Corinth, I know you look outside and that you see the ones outside the church. They're going with a big smile on their face. You're in church or you're in the synagogue and they're out in the street and they're going where they want to go and just enjoying life. Eat what they want to eat, drink what they want to drink. And the enemy brings back the taste that you had of the world when you were in the world. He brings it back. And it looks so good.
Thank you.
It looks so inviting. And he gives you the longing. Those church folk, Lord have mercy. The Lord act like the Lord is coming the next minute. Thank you, Jesus. And I'll wait till I get older. Right now, I'll enjoy myself. You're 40, 50, 60 years old, and you're talking about still enjoying yourself. You're still talking about hanging out. And you don't want to get old. I think sometimes when in my mind that I like to watch sports, and I see the basketball players, they're running and they're jumping and they're dunking the ball and they're having a good time on the floor. And my mind says, that could be you out there. Then my body says, you better sit where you at. In other words, my mind is still active. My mind still wants to do some things. But having some age behind me and some experience, I realize I can't get on the floor. I probably told you all at one time, I learned to do the somersault without touching the ground. I can stand in one place and do the flips. And my hands would never touch the ground. And so I got a little bit older. I guess I hadn't done it since I was a teenager or so. When I guess I was about 25, maybe 30 years old. I don't think it was 30, but maybe about 20, 25 years old. My mind showed me how I did it and how simple it was to do. I started to do it on the sidewalk, but I said, I'll wait till I get home and do it in the backyard. Had a little bit of sense. And got in the backyard and I was preparing myself and I went to do the flip. I got about 3/4 of the way.
Oh, it don't work.
And the feet didn't come down first. The other part met the ground. Immediately it told me, don't do that no more. And I've never tried it again since that day. I realize that my mind might tell me something my body could do, but if I listen to my body, it'll tell me I can't. Sometimes I can and sometimes I can't. Saints of God, while we are waiting for the return of our God, the reason we become complacent is because we're not preparing.
All right.
are busy looking for the pleasures of the world. Now, the things of the world, they're not all sin, but they are all distractions. There are things that we see the world get away with, and we say, what's wrong with it? We really don't want to know. And that's how come we ask the enemy, what's wrong with it? Because the enemy will tell us, ain't nothing wrong with it. See, when we begin to talk in our hearts and mind, we think that we are reasoning with ourselves. But you'll notice that a lot of times we're speaking out. And we're speaking to someone and we think we're only talking to ourselves. But the enemy is talking. His voice sounds just like our voice. So there, we say the devil is not doing anything. Well, the devil can't make me sin. He can't make me do wrong. He can only entice me in the things of the world. So when I contemplate what I want to do before I get old and have the pleasure of this world, the enemy said you can have the pleasure now while you're young. And before the Lord comes, you can repent. And it'll be all washed away, and you'll be ready to go. But every time I got to the place to satisfy myself, to come back to the Lord, the enemy was there. They see, they talking the same thing when you left. So life has its ups and downs. And we forget that the enemy has been playing the same trick for over 6,000 years. He did it with Adam. Adam knew the penalty of eating from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. For God had warned him. But Adam kept back from the tree, but it yet questioned in his mind, I wonder what it tastes like. I wonder what's in it. And he fought the feeling. You know, they tell you, don't fight the feeling. But Adam fought the feeling until God gave him a woman. And when God gave him a woman, his eyes became content with looking on the woman. It's not that the woman is the cause of Adam's failure. It is that Adam had his mind on the woman instead of on God. And thanking God that he had given him a helpmeet. And when this woman saw the tree, the enemy caught her looking, because Adam had told her what God had said to him. You may eat of all the trees in the garden. You can have fun on all these trees. You can eat the fruit of all these trees. Just don't eat of the tree of the tree of knowledge of good and evil. And so the enemy begins to woo her. I don't know if the tree had smelled to it or whatever. Maybe the blossoms, whatever may be there. And the enemy said, I bet those, the fruit of that tree really taste good. And he said, she said, I can't eat of that tree. Because God said the day that we eat of it, you will surely die. And just like he's doing today, he said, oh, you are going to surely die. He didn't say you weren't going to die. You won't surely die. Same thing today. You won't go to hell just because you do a little sin. You know, God is a good God. He will forgive you. And you just need to taste it to see what it's like. She says, no, I can't do that. And she was talking to the serpent. The serpent was on legs. I know you get the images that they draw, that the serpent is in a tree. The serpent was on the ground. And he had legs that he moved on. And he said, but he was still sneaky. He was still a viper. And he said, go ahead and try it. See, it can't hurt nothing if you try it. He told Adam that. Not you. So finally she decided she was going to eat of it. Reached up and got her some fruit. And said, this tastes good. Here, Adam. Taste it. And Adam said, well, you know we shouldn't be doing this. She said, oh, man, go ahead and taste it. See, nothing happened when the woman ate of the tree. But as soon as Adam bit into the fruit, his eyes become open. And he recognized that he was naked. For the glory of the Lord that surrounded them had now disappeared. And they could see their nakedness. When a saint of God goes out into the world and the enemy entices them to partake of it. And he says, ain't nothing going to happen. Go ahead and taste of it. You can go back if you don't like it. And they go out there and they indulge themselves. And they find that sin has a sweet taste to it. Something that becomes habitual. And they say, I got to quit. I'm not going to go back. But they went to sleep that night. Say, oh Lord, forgive me. Lord, forgive me, and I won't do it again. And God forgave them and did not strike them down dead. So they decided to try again. And they began to like it until after a while they found out that God was not going to strike them down dead. But that they had the privilege to enjoy the things of the world. And certainly you have the right to enjoy the world that God has given us. I know that as a young man, there's a lot of things that they taught us to stay away from. And as I got older, I recognized that some of these things were of man's mind, of why we could not do certain things. It was all right, but man became strict about them. But I want you to understand, when you come into understanding of God's word and begin to recognize that the enemy is not concerned with your well-being. He has nothing to offer you but that which is before you at the present moment. And that which he's offering you is not his to offer.
Right, right.
It's God that gave it to us. And we need the power of God to help us to come into recognition of what we can enjoy while we're here. I like to look at the films that they have of the earth from space. It's a beautiful place. It looks like paradise compared to the rest of the universe. It's a beautiful planet that God has put us in. He fixed it up for our habitation. He fixed it up for our glory. He set it up because he wanted us to enjoy it. But the enemy snuck into the garden where Adam had control. Glory, hallelujah. And he found Adam obeying God after Satan had been kicked out of heaven. Glory, hallelujah. He and his imps, and they saw that God had prepared even a more beautiful place than the earth for Adam. He had prepared it for his habitation. Glory, hallelujah. In other words, Adam was going to sit right next to God. He was going to enjoy the pleasures of heaven. He would be able to enjoy all the things that God had made. And the devil was very angry that he had been cast out of heaven. He and his demons, and he said, I'm not going to let that man take my place. I know more about heaven than he knows. I'm going to cut him off. Heaven is mine. I'm going to get back there. I'm going to exalt myself above the throne of God. I'm going to sit in the sides of the north. Glory, hallelujah. I'm going to make man know that I'm greater than him. Man going to fall down and worship me. Glory, hallelujah. And the devil has not given up his quest to exalt his throne above the throne of God. He's still working on it. What he's got to do is bring man into subjection of his power. And he knows that man loves pleasure. He wants to pleasurize his flesh. He's not caring about a place for man. He's not caring for the well-being of a man. God is the one that is in charge. God is the one that is worried about mankind. The Lord himself has prepared a way. Glory. He prepared the earth for it. That blue marble sitting out in space. That blue marble has been conditioned that we might enjoy life. Lord have mercy. Glory. But we began to listen to the enemy, and we begin to stumble, and we begin to fall. Glory, hallelujah. Paul said, if only we'll put in our hope on this land, how much money I can have, how many big houses, how many fine clothes, if I'm only trusting in the flesh, we're no more happy than the man walking the street. Glory, hallelujah. But Paul said, behold, I show you a mystery. Glory, hallelujah. Man's gonna die one day. Man's got to give an account of everything done in the body. God is not a forgetful God. Oh, Lord have mercy. But God has the book. God is writing down. God has everything. Glory, hallelujah. I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep. But we gonna be changed. Glory, hallelujah. Don't give up now, saints. The world don't want to hear God's word. The world think God is too strict. The word of God is driving the world. God is calling them, but they're refusing to answer. God is seeking them, but they're trying to hide from him. They say, I don't want to hear his word. I'm tired of it. Glory, hallelujah. Sometimes we get tired toiling and striving to live in this world. I know that lotto looked awful good. $1,500,000. $500 million. You said, Lord, if I had that, first I'd give to the church. I give it to the church. That's an enticement. And our mind wants to bargain with God. We want to God to know that we are mindful of the church. And we want to help the church. And God gave you a dollar. And you wouldn't even give him a dime. Thank you. But you're going to give him the tithes of $1 billion. Yes, really. Reminds me of the man that I heard about that made the $20,000. He made the $20,000. He paid $2,000 tithes. Every year, faithfully. Then God blessed him, and he made $200,000. And when he made $200,000, he was paying $20,000 a year. And he looked at it and said, "That's too much money given to that church." So he went to the pastor. He said, "Pastor, I got a problem. I was bills when I made $20,000, I paid my tithes. But now I'm making $200,000 and it's hard to pay $20,000 to the church. He said, brother, I understand what you mean. He said, so let us pray. He said, pastor started to pray and said, Lord, when he's making 20, he paid his tithes faithfully. Now he's making 200,000 and he has to pay 20,000. And it's become hard for him to pay his tithes. The pastor said, Lord, take him back to 20,000. The man said, no, no, pastor, don't pray that prayer. Don't pray that prayer. You don't want to pay 10% on a dollar.
Come on now.
Yet you're going to pay on a billion.
Yes, sir. Come on now.
You're trying to fool God.
That's right.
You're trying to pull the wool over God's eyes. But I want you to know, we as saints got hope.
Yes.
Our hope is not in the world.
Yes, sir.
Our hope is not on what we can obtain materially.
That's right.
In the world. That's not supposed to be our hope.
That's right.
But I want you to know and understand that if you do what God wants you to do,
yes,
you will get the material. Because if you remember Solomon, he said, Lord, I want you to help me. Help me to stand before your people. Teach me how to go in and out before your people. Teach me how to treat them and to tell them your word. And I will lead your people and lay down the sleep. And the Lord said, Solomon, everything you ask for, I'm going to give it to you. And I'm going to give you what you didn't ask for. Glory, hallelujah. I'm going to give you riches untold. I'm going to give you things that you need, even though you didn't ask for it. But because, glory. Thank you, Jesus. Listen, we ain't got to be here all time. We are not going to be here forever. The Lord is coming back. You don't have to believe it if you don't want it. Just let me believe it. Just let me trust in God. Just let me believe God. Woo! You say, oh, Bishop Hoke, you say God gonna give you the block. So that means he ain't coming tomorrow. I don't know that.
Hallelujah.
Woo.
Thank you, Jesus.
The block he gonna give me might be in glory.
Yes, sir. Hallelujah.
Woo.
Thank you, Jesus.
Read the 51st verse, sister.
Now this I say, behold,
behold,
I show you a mystery.
I show you a mystery.
We shall not all sleep.
We shall not all sleep.
But we shall all be changed.
But we shall all be changed. We're going to all, listen, everybody's going to be changed. Saved and unsaved. Hypocrite or not. Slipping and sliding or not. We're going to change. Read.
In a moment. In the twinkling of an eye. At the last trump. For the trumpet shall sound.
Excuse me a minute. At the last trump.
For the trumpet shall sound. And the dead shall be raised incorruptible.
And the dead shall be raised incorruptible.
And we shall be changed.
And we shall be changed. My hope is in the change.
My hope
is getting me delivered. I hope my wife will be in that change. I hope my children will be in that change. I hope my grandchildren will be in that change. But I can't change them. I can't put them in there. I got to get me in there. My fervent prayer is, Lord, save me. Deliver me. Help me to preach your word. Help me to teach your people. Help me to glorify your name. Help me to be ready. Thank you, Jesus. Read.
For this corruptible
must put on incorruption.
And this mortal shall put on immortality. So when this corruptible
shall have put on incorruption.
And this mortal shall have put on immortality.
Then shall be brought to pass.
A saying that is written. Death is swallowed up in victory.
Death is swallowed up in victory. Look here.
Yes.
We're going to die.
Mm-hmm.
I've made my 60 plus 15. Thank God. But I'm still going to die. I don't know when, but we're going to die. I could have died when I was young, being stupid. But God kept me. He blessed me. He delivered me. He didn't have to do it. But I kept praying. Lord, have mercy. I didn't want to be a hypocrite. I wasn't trying to make nobody believe I'm saved. In fact, it got so bad in my life that I said, a brother walked past me and he said, praise the Lord, Brother Hope. I said, hi, how you doing? And he said, stop. He said, I said, praise the Lord, Brother Hope. I said, praise the Lord, Brother Hope. And I felt so ashamed. I felt so ashamed that I had to say, praise the Lord, Brother Brown. He said, all right. I felt very little because I was trying not to be a hypocrite. But I wanted to be in church. And the enemy was fighting me. I'm going around the very persons that I didn't want to be like. And I knew that the enemy was working on me. But when he said, praise the Lord, he didn't have to stop. He lived in Inkster. I lived in Detroit. It was just by chance that he walked by me. And he said, praise the Lord. Just that little bit. And I got my mind right with God. I ain't gonna let the devil fool me no more. My hope is not in this world. If only in this world you have hope, I want you to understand, you're gonna lose it. You can't hold on to it. You may feel good right now. And you're pretty smart. Glory, hallelujah. Because you can get around the saints. Glory, hallelujah. You don't have to go to heaven if you don't want to. But my desire is to see Jesus. My desire is to glorify him who died for me.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well,
I didn't go down in the water in vain. I've got to see Jesus. I stayed here. I stayed here 60 years because I was 15 years old when I received the Holy Ghost. I can't hardly believe 60 years when the folk, older folk, were saying that they were saved. 50, 40, 50 years. I said, man, they've been saved all their life. They had no fun. That's a lie. That's a lie. I found out when I was on the job of talking to folk, they ain't had no fun. Sinners to their heart. And they haven't been to Inkster yet. It's crazy. God's got more for you than the world has for you. Saints, don't get upset for those who want to go astray. Let them go astray. Mary had a little lamb. Is that it? His fleece was white as snow. No, that's not the one. That's not the one I want.
Where the Mary went, lamb was going to go?
I forgot now. But y'all heard the fairy tales. God cares more for us than the devil. Devil says he cares because he wants you to have some fun. He ain't care nothing about your fun. He don't care nothing about your fun. He just hope you die in the midst of it. He wants to cut you off in the midst of it. And you believe him. You mad at anybody that wants to tell you to get right. And all they're doing is showing you how much they love you. But you ain't got enough sense to hear that. You want to do something else first. You want to do something first. I want you to go out and do what you want to do first. Have yourself a good time. Put your hope where you desire. Love yourself. If you know what love is. Enjoy yourself. There's a change coming. There is a change coming. I know you're mad at Bishop Hope. But that's all right. I know they're going to get mad at me when I preach anyway. I know. I know they don't want to hear me preach. Because I ain't preaching Daniel in the lion's den. All right. And if I preach Daniel in the lion's den, you still won't like me. If I preach Elijah on a chariot, you still won't like me. Because I want to end up with Jesus.
All right.
And that's who you don't like.
That's right. That's
it. And when you wake up, it just may be too late. Mm. It's time to turn it around and serve the Lord. Come on, Sister Holloway.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Yes, I want to see him look upon his face. There to see forever of his saving grace. On the streets of glory, let me lift my voice. Cares are past, home at last, ever to rejoice. Yes, I want to see him look upon his face. There to see forever of his saving grace. On the streets of glory,
let me lift my voice. Cares are past, home at last, ever to rejoice. Yes, I want to see him, look upon his face, sing y'all.
Forever.
Of his saving grace.
On the streets of
glory, let me lift my voice. Cares are past, home at last, ever to rejoice. Amen. The word has gone out to the household of faith. Amen. Jesus is coming. Amen. Whether you believe it or not, Jesus is coming. Hallelujah. Amen. They might be saying it for a long time now, but he is coming. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. On the news last week, they had a new planet that they discovered. Amen. It's supposed to be as big as the earth. They call it Planet 9. Amen. Call it Planet 9. I thought about the pastor when he said, hallelujah, that might be somewhere we can go. Amen. That might be. Amen. That might be where we're going. Amen. God, how can you miss that all these years? Amen. As big as the earth, how can you miss it? Amen. They call it Planet 9. God is coming back. Amen. And it's in the news every day. Amen. The signs are all around us. He is on his way back. Amen. But I want to be ready. I want to be ready when he comes. Amen. Amen. If you have not been baptized in Jesus' name, amen, it's time to come. It's time to run to the water. Hallelujah. Amen. It's time to stop playing with your soul. You don't want to be left here. Hallelujah. They got shows on TV talking about left behind. Amen. I don't want to be left behind. Hallelujah. It's not going to be a pretty thing. Amen. I want to be ready when he comes. I want to get it right the first time. Hallelujah. I want to be caught up in the first resurrection. Hallelujah. I don't want to wait around to see what's going on. I don't want to go to Jerusalem. I want to be caught up. Amen. And meet him in the air. Hallelujah. As I look across the congregation, there may be somebody out there that wants to go down in Jesus' name. It's time to come. Amen. We have water, we have clothing, and we have someone to baptize you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. You should be running to the altar. Amen. And let one of these sisters pray for you. Amen. Amen. And talk about, amen, being baptized in Jesus' name. Amen. We're not going to prolong the time. Amen. But we would wish that you would make up your mind before it's too late. Amen, to be baptized in his name. Hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together for the word of God. Hallelujah. Amen. The Lord is good. Amen. And it's getting better and better. Hallelujah. We're going to ask the deacon.